Hi, I'm Helle. Today I'm going to take a look at Kalewala, Tale of Sampo. And the version I have of the game is a prototype game. And this game will be on Kickstarter the 13th of April. And I will make sure to make a link in the description for the Kickstarter campaign. And this game is a team play, so you will divide up in two teams. And one team will play as Pujola, and the other team will play as Vainola. And the Vainola team, they have a Sampo token, which the Pujola team really would like to get their hands on. So they will in the game chase the Vainola team and see if they can catch their leader that is carrying the Sampo token and get it from him. First, I will give you an overview of the rules for the game, and then I will talk about the game. In Kalewala, you have two teams competing with each other. One team is chasing the other team. The Pujola team, they are chasing the Vainola team's leaders. And they especially want the leader that is carrying the Sampo token. The first game you play, it is recommended that you will go from spot number 3 down to spot number 1. And the Vainola team, they need to get their leader that is carrying the Sampo token down to number 1 before he is caught by the Pujola team or before too many traps have been triggered in the game. Each team, they will start with 3 leaders. And for each leader, you will have power card, you will have the leader card, and then you will get 3 resource cards. At the start of the game, you will be dealt 9 resource cards, and you have to divide them among your 3 leaders. It is recommended for your first game that you will divide them so they will each get 1 of each color. And this is the Pujola team's setup. And they also start with 12 traps. They have to place the traps on the map, on between the different numbers on the roads. We have placed the Pujola leaders up in the mountain, but they all start at this space. On the other side of the board, we have the Vainola team, and they have to choose at the start of the game who is going to carry this Sampo token. On each side of the board, you can see what you can do in the game, which actions you have. So you have the Vainola instructions on this side of the board and the Pujola instructions on the other side of the board. On this side of the board, you can see the opponent leader's abilities. And each leader, they can use their ability 1 time during their turn. And we have some scenarios that can be activated. If a leader enters a space like this or this or this on the board, then they can activate one of these scenarios so you can get more leaders. And you would be able to get 1 of these leaders out here if you win a scenario. The Pujola team will decide where to place their traps and place their traps on the board. They hope to catch some of the Vainola leaders in their traps. The Vainola team will first take actions, a max of 1 per leader. Then they will make their movement, and then they have to make a trap announcement. For their actions, they can give up a card. They can discard a card to Tuomas, which is this area here. Each of the team, they have their own Tuomas area. As an action, you can discard a red card so you can challenge a space if you want to have a combat. And then you can discard a golden card to draw a character card, a tail card, or a boat token. When you have these boat tokens, you will need these to travel on water. And we have some tail cards, and we have some character cards, which are these cards. And then you can activate a location, you can activate a scenario if you are on one of the scenario spaces, this space, or this space. And then if you are on one of these spaces with this tree, then you can activate that one to regain a card you would have discarded out here to Tuomas. And the leaders, they all have an ability which they can use during their turn. The abilities on the other cards are only activated if they are used in combat and you win the combat. With this leader, you can draw a card for your action and it won't cost you anything. So he could use just this ability here to draw a character card and add it to his hand. And this player might discard a card so he would get 1 more movement point. And you will discard your card out here to Tuomas. And then this player,
He might also want a new card, so he might just discard this card. He would discard it here, and he would then draw a card and add it to his hand. So after the vanilla team has taken actions with the leaders, then it's time to move their leaders. This leader can move 3 spaces because he gave up a silver card. So instead of just 2, he can then move 3 spaces. And we want him to get quick down to here so they can win the game. So he might go from here, 1, 2, and maybe down there. Or maybe down here. I think he'll go down here. There's a lot of ways he can go from there. This one might follow along, 1, 2. And with this leader, I think he will go 1, 2, this way. And then we have trap announcement. And if some leaders go the same way, you only have to announce one of the path. So these two, they both use this path. So I will say 3 to 22. And then the Pajoli team, they will check to see if there is a trap here. The other team announced they went from 3 to 22 and there are no traps there. But this means that someone has gone this way. So they could place a guy here so they know that they have traveled this way. They announced that there aren't any trap, so nothing will happen. We don't have to say anything about the other paths that we took. But they know we have traveled down here. So they know at least one leader has gone this way. And then with this one, we will say 3 to 23. And they will check to see if there is a trap. And the Vinoli team mentioned number 3 to 23. Here is a trap number 1. So we will take the trap number 1 card. The other team, they have to announce which leader went this way. And that leader is now in trouble. And then we can read the flavor text. And for the next movement, this leader may only move one path. For the rest of the game, he may not use the action of destroying a silver card, so he cannot earn more movement points. And the other team will announce that it was this guy that was caught in a trap. So the Pajoli team knows that he went this way. They only announce 2 paths, so they don't know if there are 2 players that went this way or 2 of their characters that went this way. And now it's the Pajoli team's turn. And they will first move their leaders, then they will do 1 action per leader, and then they will burn the 1 trap with the lowest number. And the Pajoli team, they will win if they catch the Sampo bearer twice. They have to, the first time if they catch him and they win a battle, it will get destroyed and each leader will get a piece of the Sampo token, and then they have to catch just one of the leaders and win a battle against him, then they can win victory. Or they will also win in this scenario if all the traps, they are gone. And they will burn one at the end of the round. And if people, they trap in a trap, then they will also get removed from the game. And they have the same actions as the other team. So first they will move their leaders and they also start from this space. And they know one went down here, so they would probably send someone this way, and they will also go this way. And if he went 2 spaces this way, he would be here, and he could actually be there or there. So they would send a guy over to this space. And they can move 3 spaces, so there could be one here. If one of them did use a silver card, they could be here, here or here. Maybe he would go 2 spaces. And then this guy could go 3 spaces. And then they would have to do their actions. And I think he thinks that this guy, he could also be down there. But I think he thinks he's there. And he could then say, I will challenge this space. So he will discard a red card to Tunula. Then he will ask if there's any leaders here at space number 26. And there is this guy, he is actually at 26. And he has to announce who he is and if he is the Sampo bearer. And if there were more leaders, they have to announce all the leaders. And if we move 2 leaders over here, then we only had to reveal one of them if we wanted to. We could also reveal both of them. So a combat will take place. And this each leader, they will be able to play 1 card.
They will reveal a card simultaneously. And the battle is really simple in this game. A red card beats a gold card beats a silver card, and a silver card beats a red card.
So each leader will now choose a card. And you can always see which cards have been discarded to Tonula, so you know a bit about which cards the other players they have.
Both leaders, they will choose a card, and then they will reveal the card at the same time. If they both have the same color, then we will look at Tonula to see if they have any cards out here. And this player does have one card, so he will win the battle. That means that this card, for the losing side, it will be discarded.
And with the winning card, if there is this symbol down here, then you get to activate this action down here. And with this, check through the character deck and reorganize it in any way. So we can go through this deck and arrange the cards in any order we want to. And the winning team, they get to keep their card. And the other leaders would also take an action. It's the same actions on both sides you have. And then after all leaders, they have taken an action, then we would go to burn a trap. And then we would find the lowest number. It's number 2. So we would remove this trap and we would then remove the trap card. Then it would be the other team's turn again. And that is the way you play the game. The Vernone team will first take actions for their leaders, then they will move their leaders, and then to have to announce paths they have went through, so see if they activate any traps. And on the Pojola team, their leaders, they will first move, and then they will perform actions.
So one of the things in this game is the battles you have in the game, and you will be chased by the other players if you're playing as the Vainola team. And the Pojola team, they need to figure out where the other team's leaders they are going. They have to run after them and fight them so they can be able to gain this Sampo token. First they will need to defeat the Sampo bearer and it will get broken, and each leader on the Vainola team, they will get one of these broken pieces. And if they can defeat one more leader, or they can have all their traps being activated and burned, then they can win the game. And if the Pojala team or the Vainola team have more leaders at a space, then each of the leaders, they can participate in the battle, and they can use one card per leader. But if you have more than one leader, they have to play the same color of cards. They can't play a yellow and a red card. Then they would have to play 2 red cards or 2 yellow cards if they want to play 2 cards to see if they could win the battle. And when you have these battles, you can always look on the table on which cards the other team they have discarded. Because if you kind of play the same card, then it will be the player that has the most of these out here that will win the battle. And if you don't win a battle, then you will lose all your cards. So that's a bit rough in this game. This game is kind of a racing game. You have to try to figure out what you think your opponent will do and then do something else so they won't catch you. And you also have to figure out how much you want to spread out. Because if you spread all your leaders out when you are the Vainola team, then you might activate more traps. And if all the traps, they are gone from the game, then you will also lose the game. This first scenario is very short. We are only going from this space down to here. You can have longer scenarios where we go down here or down here. And that will happen more during the game. And then you will get to activate some of the scenarios. Or maybe you can go in, you can go to this space where there are these trees, where you can gain a card back from Tonola. And you might have to do this when you have to go further away so you can get some card back again. But that's a fun thing about this game. You kind of don't want to lose your cards, but they also help you in battle. If you have the same amount of cards, then the player that has the most cards out here will win the battle. So you kind of want cards out here, but you also want cards on your hand. So you have to think carefully of how you play your cards and use your cards in the game. And as a team, you have to help each other and use the abilities that the leaders they have. You have a leader that can, on one of the teams, you have a leader that can draw cards without having to discard a card. So if you follow kind of the same path, he could take a card and give cards to other leaders if they are standing in the same space. And beside these resource cards, we also have some tail cards. And there is a lot of flavor text on these cards. This is really a huge and heavy board. I think it will be different because this is a prototype game. So I don't know how the end product will be for the game. But I wish that they would make these brown roads a bit more visual, not that dark. It can be hard to see where they go if it's a bit dark when you play the game. And the cards here, I have a bit of trouble finding out which cards were a leader card, which cards were a power card and a resource card. They have told me that they will make it more visible for which type of cards you have, so it will be easier to find the cards when you have to play the game. This is a prototype game, so the design is not finished yet of everything in the game. And some of these are a bit dark, so they could be a bit lighter. And it is a team effort. You have to kind of have your leaders work together. And if they are at the same place, they can swap cards with each other. And in this case, where we had a leader that couldn't play the silver cards, he would then want to give his silver cards to one of the other players. Of course, he can use them in battle. He would be able to use them there, but that's the only thing he can then use the silver cards for. And when you play the game, you have kind of the excitement of see if you can hide from the others and see if you can announce a path you have walked through where there aren't any traps. Because you really don't want to get caught in all these traps the Pajola team they have placed on the board. And on this short road down to here, there's a lot of traps. They will well be spread more out if you have to go further when you play a longer scenario. In this game, you really have some tense moments where you have to see if you have guessed correctly in what you think your opponent will play of cards when you have battles and where to go and hide and find ways where you think your opponent won't catch you if you are the Vainola player. If you like a team versus team play and you like the hidden movement part of a game and try to see if you can outsmart your opponent, you can be smarter than them. I hope you have got a good feeling of how this game is played, so you can decide if this is something for you.
I have enjoyed my plays of Kalewala, but I have only been playing it with two players. Because of the situation we have at the moment with the coronavirus going on, I have been isolated for about 4 weeks now. And all gaming events and all meetings with friends have been cancelled. So I haven't been able to bring it out and play it with a lot of players. But I think this will be a good game to play with 4 and also up to 6 players, where you will be 2 or 3 players behind each screen and controlling the leaders. But I will have to experience that at some point when we can be together again. But this was my look at Kalewala, and I will make sure to make a link in the description for the Kickstarter campaign. Thanks for watching.